Welcome to another video from Beta CAE Systems. The current video demonstrates the new meshing toolsets and the direct functionality introduced in ANSA version 22. The mesh menu is now redesigned. In order to boost user productivity and avoid extensive mouse traveling, the buttons are grouped into workflow-based toolsets. Direct functionality is widely introduced. Scatter buttons are now merged into straightforward working buttons. And obsolete buttons were moved to the second level of the interface. So, apart from the Cell Mesh module, which contains all the updated functionality needed to create Cell Mesh, there is the Middle Mesh toolset, useful for extruded and casted parts, the Tetra Hybrid Mesh toolset, for creating Tetra and Hybrid Mesh, the Hexa Penta Mesh toolset, for Hexa and Penta Volume Mesh generation, the Wrap Mesh toolset, and the Voxel Mesh toolset. Let's start with the demonstration of the new functionality, turning to the new Cell Mesh toolset. The user can mesh the model using the new Mesh button. The target element length, as well as any other option, is obtained from the global mesh parameters defined. There are three available options of meshing. The Simple Mesh option, where the perimeters and their grids remain intact while the mesh is generated. The Perimeter Grids option, where the distribution and number of the grids can be changed but no perimeter is joined or released. And the Macro Perimeters option, where the joining of perimeters is allowed. The visibility of the joint perimeters can be activated from the corresponding button of the Faces Draw toolbar. The existing mesh can be reset with the new reset function, which comes with four different options. With the grids position option, the user can move the grids back to their origin position without erasing the mesh. With the erase mesh option, additional to the grid's origin, the mesh is also erased. The perimeter grids option, apart from erasing the mesh, changes also the number of the grids on the perimeters and their distribution, based on the mesh parameters and quality criteria. Finally, with the Macro Perimeters option, any macro perimeter that is released or joined is restored to the underlying faces. Let's have a look on the new Direct Edit functionality on an already meshed model. The functionality respects the global values of the mesh parameters and quality criteria. The user can in a direct way perform modification on nodes, edges and elements by hovering over the entities. An informative window provides guidelines and can be deactivated from the corresponding button. Depending on the entity which the cursor hovers over, mouse actions actually prompt different functions. By right-clicking on a node, a window is prompt, providing access to a number of functions. These functions always depend on the type of the currently selected entity. By dragging a node, the latter can be moved on the surface or pasted on another node. With the Tab key, the option changes to move the node normal to the surface. The shortcut key M allows the return to origin for multiple nodes instead of clicking one by one. Hovering over an edge, the available options are shown with the right mouse button. The elements can be split or swapped with one click. When the Control key is pressed, multiple edges can be selected and multiple elements can be split at once. Clicking on an edge can join the respective triangle elements. The Tab key switches to the next option, which is to collapse the selected edge. With the Control key, multiple edges can be collapsed at the same time. Finally, by right-clicking over an element, the corresponding options are shown. With just clicking on an element, the user can diagonally split it. Switching with the Tab key provides the option to split in four. The tri elements are highlighted upon hovering because they can be selected and dragged to another position. From the top section of the right-click options menu, the user can switch to the Areas Edit Direct functionality, which can also be accessed from the corresponding button on the main menu area. With this functionality, modifications can be performed on hot points, perimeters, macro areas, features, and align constraints. A hot point can be added or deleted upon left mouse clicking. By dragging a hot point to an opposing perimeter, the user can cut the macro area. In the same way, following a path of edges, the edge to perimeter functionality is available. An alternative way of cutting is also by pressing Ctrl and left-click to define the starting point of a cut. The options for a perimeter are again available under the right-click menu. Simply-click joins a perimeter or releases it if it is a joint one. The joint perimeters become visible while the pointer hovers over them. Pressing the buttons 1 or 2 on the keyboard decreases or increases the number of nodes respectively. For all these functions, there are several options available in the options list, like whether the improve function is applied along or not. The shortcut key B can be used at any time while the direct edit is enabled to bring up a brush tool to apply the improve function locally. The brush diameter can be altered with the buttons 1 and 2 on the keyboard. The selected improve function, here reconstruct, can be applied on the area where the brush tool hovers over. It is easily understandable that the direct functionality with the shortcut keys available can provide easy and fast solutions for the model cleanup. There are also multiple options to modify a macro area. For example, by pressing V as a shortcut on the keyboard, the four-sided function is activated and ready to apply on the selected macros. Again, with the B key, the brush is activated, and switching with Tab to Smooth, or again to Origin. Let's have a demo of modifying a stamp using just the direct edit functionality. With the Q key, the user can switch between the elements and areas direct edit mode. Two trias can be joined to form a quad element. Opposing trias can be moved and eliminated using drag and drop functionality. The nodes number on the perimeter is changed. Finally, mesh smoothing is easy using the brush. With the F key, a macro area can be directly freezed or unfreezed. When the stamp feature is ready, its mesh can be easily copied to similar stamps by dragging it on the latter while being on feature draw mode. In the feature draw mode, the user has direct access to the recognized features by just clicking on them. For example, in the case of a fillet, the treatment card opens with all the available options and the number of rows is defined. In the same way, when clicking on a hole feature, the treatment card pops up. Here, a zone with 2 mm width is set, and the treatment is applied upon clicking OK, always respecting the global mesh parameters and quality criteria values. Thank you very much for watching this video.